Good morning, my dear friends. Let us continue with the second part of our lesson, India Agriculture. First part, we discussed the importance of agriculture, type of agriculture, etc. Today, we are dealing with some other aspect of Indian agriculture. Method of agriculture. Type of agriculture and method of agriculture are different. Generally, three methods have been followed in our country for agriculture. One is organic farming, then sustainable farming, then mixed farming. Let us talk about organic farming. Organic farming nowadays is more in many parts of our country. You know, we were trying to improve the production. We were using fertilizer, pesticides, likewise all the modern available item to get more production. But when we use fertilizer and pesticides in the field, it has some adverse effect on our hygiene. You know, we have to think about our health also. By consuming this item which contain toxic things, we are getting disease our own way. To avoid it, there is a trend among farmers and people to go for organic farming. In organic farming, chemical fertilizer, pesticides, insecticides, etc. are not at all used, or their use is minimized. Instead of it, other natural fertilizer all are used. Cow dung, likewise also earthworm fertilizer, composite fertilizer, etc. are used. Likewise, instead of these pesticides, we use cow urine, neem solvent, buttermilk, tobacco added mixer, etc. Tobacco, cut it and make, put it in water, and that solution we can use as a material for killing pets. This is all common. Such a way, if we concentrate on all this, use of fertilizer is reduced or maximum avoided. Likewise, organic items are used for water, boosting the growth of plant. This item, when we are getting, be it crop, be it fruits, be it food grains, it is free from the content of toxic item. So there is a trend among farmers to go for water organic farming. Organic farming, and when crop are taken such a way that crop are free from water, all type of poisonous items and content. It is nutritious and also healthy. So we can use fruits, vegetables, food grains, all such a way. Little bit of price may be more. So this is a method of farming, organic farming. Means once more, fertilizer, pesticides, etc. are not used. Country made things are used to produce goods and crops, vegetables, etc. From that, we can maintain our health. We can concentrate on hygienic matter. Then second type of farming is sustainable farming. What does sustainable farming mean? Sustainable farming means sustain the peculiarity of the soil. Soil contains so many nutrients. Suppose we are using fertilizer, pesticides, etc. continuously, what happened? Fertilizer help the plant to suck up or take nutrient from the soil. Soil is upper part of the layer, upper layer of the soil, you know, upper layer of the land is called soil. And when all nutrients are taken, what will happen? Then land become barren. Continuous use of fertilizer, pesticide make a land infertile or barren. So to avoid it, what other methods are formed? Use of cow dung, other things are used. Likewise also usage of, likewise also rotation of crops. Same place, same crop is cultivated continuously, it also reduces the nutrient of the soil. Instead of it, rotation of crop are practiced. First, any other crop will be food crop may be cultivated afterwards, pulses may be cultivated so that it can maintain the fertility of the soil forever. This soil is for us and also for the coming generation. If you take maize from this soil, one day this soil will be useless. To maintain and sustain the fertility of the soil, this sustainable farming is practiced so that we can maintain the fertility of the soil. When pulses are cultivated, the root of the pulses that will suck up nitrogen from atmosphere and store it in their root. When the plant get decayed, this nutrient will be spread in the soil and land become more fertile. So rotation of the crop is used. Likewise, chemical fertilizer, pesticides, etc. use is minimized so that such a way fertility of the soil is maintained in sustainable farming. Third one is mixed farming. You know, 59 to 60% of our people are farmers. That's the main occupation of our people. You know, farm, when we cultivate, we are getting so many things. The same we can utilize for other activities. For example, cattle rearing can be carried out along with the farming. So likewise, poultry, it is also possible in the farm. We can have poultry farming. The same way, fishery pond we can make, and there we can cultivate varieties of fishes, and it is good things we can get from there. Fishery is also practiced. Likewise, beekeeping also a profitable occupation. These all, cattle rearing, poultry, fishery, beekeeping, all we can continue with the farming. When farmers are doing all this work together, their income will increase, economic standard of the people will increase. Now we can think about some of the important crop of our country. Our crop are of three varieties. We call kari crop, ravi crop and set crop. Kari crop is cultivated in the rainy season. We are getting rainfall from June to September. So we cultivate June to November. This time whatever crop we are cultivating, we call kari crop or monsoon. Rain is the main source, main support for the farmers to do agriculture. Paddy, maize, jowar, millet, cotton, groundnut, mug, match, etc. are coming in water, kari crop. And another crop is ravi crop. Ravi crop are the crop which we cultivate during the winter season. Medium climate condition exists, then we cultivate. Its time is from November to March, April. Which are the crop coming in ravi crop? Wheat, gram, barley, mustard, linseed. Nowadays, everywhere we can see wheat field growing with the best of greenery. So it is a condition required for water cultivation of wheat. Likewise, set crop. This is generally cultivated in the summertime. Which are the crop? Crop which are growing during summertime are called a set crop. This is cultivated from March to June. Generally, mango, many fruits all are coming in that. Which are the coming? Paddy, maize, groundnut, watermelon, cucumber, likewise muskmelon, all are cultivated in this time. So crop have been divided into three sections: kari crop, ravi crop and set crop. Now let us talk about some other agricultural product of our country. Main farm cultivating items: paddy. Maximum area of our land is devoted for cultivation of paddy. Paddy means rice. India is the second biggest producer of rice after China. And maximum people of our India are eating what rice as their staple food. Especially coastal area, wheat is a main item. China is a leading producer of the rice in the world. Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Orissa, West Bengal, Telangana, all these states, there is a cultivation of paddy or rice. Rice need a temperature up to 20 degree and above, and also more than 100 centimeter rainfall. Water is needed. If water is available, irrigation facilities are available, we can cultivate barley 3 times in a year. Next is wheat. Wheat is a second important crop of our country. States like Punjab, Haryana, UP, Punjab, all this region we have cultivation of wheat. In Gujarat also, Balia, such area it is cultivated. Balia wheat is very famous. Wheat is called the king of all the grains. It contains nutritious things, likewise carbohydrate, likewise also other protein all. So that it is called the king of all the grains. Likewise, Punjab, Haryana, such regions are the region it is cultivated maximum. Punjab is called wheat bowl of our country. It need a rainfall less than 100 cm of rainfall. Likewise also temperature between 40 degrees Celsius. Such a situation. Generally, it is cultivated as a rabi crop. Then jowar, millet and maize. Jowar is cultivated in the area in which rainfall is getting less. Some of the states, Maharashtra, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, such places it is cultivated. It need a rainfall below 125 cm and a temperature between 25 to 40 degree. Means it doesn't need so much temperature or rainfall. We can cultivate even if water availability is less. The same way, millet. Millet is known as grains of laborers. It need a 40 to 50 degree rainfall. It is cultivated in many parts of our country. Wherever rainfall is less, such area millet is cultivated. Same way, maize. Maize is cultivated in Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Kashmir and many other places. From maize also we are taking biofuel and all. So its use is very important. The hilly region, it is a kari crop and also a rabi crop. And we can have a discussion about another topic in another day. Main topic we discussed are different type of crop and also details about paddy, wheat, jowar, millet and maize. Let us stop here.